Afternoon. Okay.
Good
Good afternoon.
afternoon, sir.
Yeah, very good afternoon. Good. Nice to see you all. In this class, let us have a small introduction to the next play in the paper Shakespeare, that is Macbeth. So earlier we had seen a comedy, that is The Merchant of Venice. And for this lecture, I would like to give a brief introduction to the tragedy Macbeth. Before we get into the text, my dear students, please remember Shakespeare's works can be classified into broadly three categories or four categories in general: comedies, tragedies, histories, and romances. Basically, three categories means histories, tragedies, and comedies. So when we read a comedy, we had some conventional elements for a typical elements for a comedy. That is, we have seen in The Merchant of Venice, the conflicts will be very normal conflicts. Themes will be about love, friendship, mistaken identity, a quest for power, or cheating someone, or misunderstandings between relationships. Usually, that kind of themes we come across in comedies. And finally, we also have happy endings. The endings will be very happy, right? And what happens is nobody dies. There won't be any bloodshed. Naturally, there won't be any bloodshed or violence in comedies. And all kinds of conflicts will be resolved in the end, leading to the union or forgiving and forgetting the mistakes of others. People tend to forget the mistakes and they join together. There is no much violence or bloodshed. We have happy endings. Usually, we have marriage or marriages. Multiple marriages may take place in comedies. So, lighter themes were handled by Shakespeare for comedies. And on the other hand, just the typical opposite for comedies or tragedies. As the name itself suggests, tragedies deal with serious issues, serious concepts, right? Such plays deal with very serious issues where we have bloodshed, loss of lives, and sometimes the protagonist or the central character himself will die in the end. So naturally, we have a sorrowful and sad endings for tragedies, just the opposite for comedies. In comedies, we have happy endings, usually with marriage or marriages. In tragedies, we come across serious issues, right? Issues of revenge, murder, assassinations, right? Being treacherous people, traitors, Nambike Drohigal, people who become traitors, people who try to capture power through what is a crooked means, hook and crook means of any negative means, right? Evil methods. They adopt even sorcery. Such plays are called as the tragedies. And in such tragedies, we come across sorrowful and sad endings. Because I told you, even the protagonist or the central character will die in the end, leading to creating an important feeling as mentioned by Aristotle. When he defines about the tragedy, Aristotle talks about the feelings of pity and fear, hamartia. My dear students, please make a note of this term, hamartia, HAMARTIA. Hamartia, purgation of pity and fear. purgation of pity and fear. Make a note of it. Purgation of pity and fear in the minds of the audience. This is what the desired effect Aristotle aims at a tragedy. So in a tragedy, Aristotle says, the dramatist tries to evoke pity in the minds of the audience for the protagonist. The audience must feel pity or feel sorry for the loss of or the downfall of the tragic hero. The tragic hero is going to lose the battle, is going to lose the fight. But the audience will feel sorry for him, will feel pity for him. They will take pity on him. So that is the effect Aristotle talks about. There is another feeling called the element of fear. Fear psychosis. Fear psychosis. Make a note of it. Fear psychosis. Even Sigmund Freud, Carl Jung, they all talk about fear psychosis. Right? We also have bad dreams that are called as nightmares. Nightmares. Nightmares means the terrible dreams. Right? We come across nightmares in our dreams because due to we may be afraid of something. In our deep-rooted unconscious mind, we may feel fear for certain things. For such some people, we feel afraid of snakes. For some people, we may feel afraid of ghosts. Right? Imaginary things. But the fear psychosis will be always there and they emerge as dreams. They may emerge as dreams. That is called as fear psychosis. So, in tragedies, Aristotle talks about the evocation of two important feelings. What are they? Pity and fear in the minds of the audience. The dramatist must be successful in evoking the feelings of pity and fear in the minds of the audience. Okay, you understood pity. We feel sorry for the protagonist because he has undergone a great fall. Okay, we understand that. What about the feeling of fear? What about the feeling of fear? What is the feeling of fear mentioned by Aristotle? Anybody? We as audience should not dare to commit such crimes in our real life also. Am I audible? Are you able to follow me, my dear students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. Thank you. Yes, sir. The audience are supposed to be afraid of evil, afraid of committing evil. The audience should not dare to commit evil things in their lives. தங்களுடைய வாழ்க்கையில் நம்ம டிராஜிக் ஹீரோ செய்தது போன்ற ஒரு தவறை செய்யக்கூடாது அப்படிங்கிற பயத்தை மனதில் உருவாக்க வேண்டும். சோ வி ஃபீல் சாரி ஃபார் த சென்ட்ரல் கேரக்டர் ஆர் த புரோட்டாகனிஸ்ட் ஆர் த ஹீரோ. ஹீரோ இஸ் அ வெரி க்ரூட் டேர்ம், அன் ஆர்டினரி டேர்ம் யூஸ்ட் பை லேமென். வி ஆர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் லிட்ரேச்சர், வி ஹாவ் டு யூஸ் த வேர்ட் கால்டு புரோட்டாகனிஸ்ட். ஐ திங்க் யூ ஆர் ஆல் ஃபெமிலியர் அபவுட் த வேர்ட் புரோட்டாகனிஸ்ட், ரைட்? த சென்ட்ரல் கேரக்டர். So, the central character undergoes pain and suffering. And there is one great element which is responsible for his downfall. What is the element? That is called as, anybody? Tragic flaw. That element is called as, please make note of it. I am typing everything and posting it in the chat box. Please make note of it. That is called as a tragic flaw. Anybody, what do you mean by tragic flaw? Any idea about that? Flaw means error or mistake. Flaw means error or mistake. So what happens in a tragic flaw? That is hamartia. Hamartia mentioned one. We call it as hamartia. Hamartia. Right. This hamartia, feeling of hamartia, refers to the tragic flaw committed by the protagonist, the central character. Error in judgment, right? It may be error in judgment. What is error in judgment? Like in the case of King Lear. When we talk about Shakespeare, we always talk about the four great tragedies of Shakespeare. We talk about four major tragedies of Shakespeare. What are they? King Lear,
Macbeth, Othello, King Lear, and Hamlet.
King Lear, Hamlet, Othello, and Macbeth. All these four great tragedies, they represent the protagonist names themselves. It talks about King Lear, Hamlet talks about Hamlet himself, Othello also talks about King Othello, Macbeth also talks about Macbeth. These are the four major tragedies of Shakespeare. Please make note of it. In all these three, I'll just take these four examples. I'm not taking other tragedies now. When we talk about Shakespeare, I am talking about only four major tragedies now. In the case of King Lear, what is this hamartia? Error in judgment. What is error in judgment? He failed to judge his own daughters. King Lear had three daughters, and the two elder daughters cheated him. They became traitors and they blinded him and they chased him away without food and water into a desert. He was made to suffer and die a painful death. The third daughter is a really lovable daughter, but King Lear failed to understand her character and nature, and she also tried to help him in the end, but unfortunately the other two daughters and their son-in-laws, they cunningly killed King Lear as well as the third daughter, the younger daughter, youngest daughter. What is the tragic flaw of King Lear now? The tragic flaw is error in judgment. He failed to understand the real nature and character of his three daughters. First two daughters were cunning daughters. The last one is a really a good daughter. But he immediately, in the beginning, King Lear mistakenly thinks that the youngest daughter is a traitor. But time reveals that the two daughters, the elder daughters, two elder daughters were turned to be traitors actually. The third one was really a loving daughter. Okay. What is the case of Hamlet here? Hamlet, Prince Hamlet, in his case, the tragic flaw lies with himself. Again, what is the problem with him? The problem of procrastination. Make a note of it. The problem of procrastination. Procrastination. What is the procrastination? Failure to make decisions at the right time. Postponing things unnecessarily. Unduly he is postponing time. Unnecessarily, without making any decisions, he postpones things. He comes across so many dilemmas. Dilemmas means conflicts. Whether to believe in ghost or not. Whether to believe in Bible or not. Whether the ghost is really his father is the ghost really his father or not. Whether to believe the words of his father or not. Whether to take revenge on his uncle or not. Whether to trust his own mother or not. Whether to trust his own lady love or not. Right? He has confusions in everything. அத்தனையும் குழப்பம். அம்மாவை நம்புறதா வேண்டாமா? அப்பா உண்மையிலேயே கொலை செய்யப்பட்டாரா இல்லையா? சித்தப்பா தான் அந்த கொலைக்கு காரணமா இல்லையா? வந்திருக்க கோஸ்ட் நம்புறதா வேண்டாமா? பைபிள் சேஸ் தெர் ஆர் நோ கோஸ்ட் பட் தெர் இஸ் அ கோஸ்ட் ஸ்டாண்டிங் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் ஓன் ஐஸ். சோ ஹாம்லெட் வாஸ் டார்ன் பிட்வீன் தீஸ் கான்ஃப்ளிக்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஹி ஃபெயில்ஸ் டு மேக் டெசிஷன்ஸ் அட் த ரைட் மூமெண்ட். த வில்லன் டேக்ஸ் எ டெசிஷன் அண்ட் தென் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தட் Hamlet, as well as his mother, his friends, his lady love, everybody dies because of procrastination. Postponing one's decision is called as procrastination. Have you noted it down? Okay. Third one is Othello. What is Othello? Othello's tragic flaw is suspicion for his wife. He did not trust his own wife. He became suspicious. He believed the words of Iago. And his own friend, actually a friend turned to be a traitor. Friend turned to a traitor. Nambike drohiyaga marana or nanban. Right? He did not trust his own wife and murders his own wife. And finally, he also dies, commits suicide. So, in Othello's case, what is the problem? Lack of trust. He did not trust his own wife. Suspicion. That is the problem. Finally, we have Macbeth. That is the play we are going to see right now. So, before we get into the text, let me first trace the sources of Macbeth. The chief source for Macbeth was Holinshed's Chronicles. Make a note of it. The chief source for the play Macbeth was Holinshed's Chronicles. I will type it in the chat box. Make a note of it. Chronicles is the name of the work written by Holinshed. Holinshed is the writer. The name of the work is Holinshed. The name of the work is Chronicles. Chronicles means stories, right? Fables. In these chronicles, Macbeth was taken, the theme of Macbeth was taken from Holinshed's Chronicles. So, please don't think that Shakespeare has committed the sin of plagiarism. Don't think like that. Shakespeare did not like that. Shakespeare had stolen, you cannot accuse Shakespeare for having stolen the theme from Holinshed. Holinshed has handled the theme of Macbeth in a different way, but Shakespeare had given a different treatment. So we cannot accuse Shakespeare. Okay. So, in Holinshed's Chronicles, the background is the same, that is of Scotland, right? It is written in the year 1527 by Hector Boyce. Macbeth's story appears in 1527 in a work called Scotorum Historiae. You need not bother about other things. You just remember one of the major chief sources of Macbeth was Holinshed's Chronicles. That is enough. Right? There are many versions available. Okay. So, the dramatic purpose of producing a more exciting story is found, and the theme of usurping the power from the king has been taken from Holinshed's original story. And in the olden days, you might come across a theory called the divine right theory of kings. Is anybody aware of it? The divine right theory. What is the divine right theory? Kings were appointed by gods themselves. The kings were direct messengers of gods in heaven. The kings in earth, the kings on earth are direct representatives of gods themselves. That is the theory called the divine right theory. Right? That is called as the divine right theory. R-I-G-H-T. Divine right. They have the right to rule. And what is the next, what is the major feature of divine right theory? Only the legal heirs of the kings can become the rulers of the land. Only the natural heirs, H-E-I-R-S, heirs means varisugal. Raja udaya neradiyana ratta varisugal mattume marubadiyum raja vaga varamudiyum. This power is anointed on the kings by gods themselves. This is called as the divine right theory. Right. So, what happens here is, in the case of Macbeth, I told you Macbeth is going to be a tragedy, right? King James I has a great influence in the making of Macbeth. King James I, make a note of it, King James I had a great influence in designing the character of Macbeth. There is another reference to the origin of Macbeth, that is by the work of Seneca, Seneca, a famous Latin and Greek tragedian. Seneca, Seneca. Seneca is a famous Greek tragedian, a Latin tragedian, wrote in Latin, in which we come across great similarities to Lady Macbeth's character, that is wife of Macbeth. I'll give you some time, make note of it. The Lady Macbeth's character has great similarities in the work of Seneca. Seneca. When Macbeth was written and published, the ruler was none other than James the First. So, in order to uphold the divine right theory of the kings, and if any individual tries or attempts to capture the power of the king through evil means, it is a punishable crime and also a sin. My dear students, you may understand the difference between a crime and a sin. Right? Am I right? What is a crime? Crime is a punishable offense according to law, the law created by human beings on earth. What about the term called sin? Anybody? Can anyone highlight the meaning for the word sin? My dear students, can anyone unmute your mic and tell me? Hello? Anyone? Even you might have come across the same word sin in your textbook, government textbooks in schools. Untouchability is a sin. What do you mean by a sin? Anybody?
Pavam.
Chulunga. Meenakshi chulunga.
Pavam, sir.
Very good. Pavachayal. It is a sin. Sin refers to sin. The word pavam nala enna artham na? It is a punishable offense by God, not by law. Crime is a punishable offense. Sin is a punishable offense by God himself. What about the Bible, biblical words of sin? The Bible says the reward of sin is death. The wages of sin is death. Pavathin sambalam maranam. Pavam seiravangalukku enna pa kadaikuma? Maranam. That is what the Bible says. Right. Nobody should commit sins in our life. Namma life la yarume seiyakoda vishayam enadhu? Sins. We are all human beings. We commit mistakes, small errors. Right? That is okay. That will be forgiven by God. We ask for forgiveness. Right? We go to confession chamber in the church, even in the temple, even in the mosque, we cry to Lord to forgive our mistakes, forgive our trespasses. Right? Lord is very gracious. Lord is very kind enough. That is why we go to the temples and cry. Right? And ask for forgiveness. God is also kind-hearted so that he will forgive us. But what happens in churches, we have a chamber called confession chamber. In that confession chamber, the priest will be sitting inside, and the victim or the devotee has to confess the sins he has committed, the crimes he has committed, and the pastor will cleanse his sin. God will forgive and cleanse your sin. Please don't repeat the sin you have committed already. Because there is always forgiveness. There is hope for mankind to change one's ways. Senja thappa thirundi enna seiyanum? There is a beautiful term in English called, make a note of it, seitha thavarai unarndhu thirunduvadharku oru per irukku. Anybody? Can anyone mention the word? I have given in the chat box. Repentance. That is called as a repentance. We have to repent for our mistakes. Seitha thavarai mulumayaga manadara unarndhu enna seiyanum? திருந்துறதுக்கு பேரு ரிப்பென்ட். வேர்பா யூஸ் பண்ண ரிப்பென்ட், நவுனா யூஸ் பண்ண ரிப்பென்டன்ஸ், மனம் திருந்துதல். ஃபீலிங் சாரி ஃபார் த மிஸ்டேக்ஸ் வி ஹவ் கமிட்டட், செய்த தவறை மனப்பூர்வமாக உணர்ந்து திருந்துதல். ஓகே, திஸ் இஸ் வாட் வி கம் அக்ராஸ் இன் மேக்பெத் ஆல்சோ. வி கம் அக்ராஸ் சின்ஸ், ரைட்? வாட் இஸ் தி சின்? தி சின் ஆஃப் கில்லிங் த கிங் ஹிம்செல்ஃப். தட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் சின் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ரெஜிசைட். Make a note of it. Killing the king is called as regicide. There are many sides in English. Killing one own self is called a suicide. தன்னைத்தானே கொலை பண்ணிக்கிறதுக்கு பேர் சூசைட். பெத்த அப்பாவை கொலை பண்றதுக்கு பேர் பேட்ரிசைட். கில்லிங் ஒன்ஸ் ஓன் மதர் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் மேட்ரிசைட். கில்லிங் ஒன்ஸ் ஓன் சிப்லிங்ஸ் ஆர் கால்ட் அஸ் ஃப்ராட்ரிசைட். FRATRICIDE. சைட் மீன்ஸ் கில்லிங், ரைட். ரெஜிசைட் மீன்ஸ் கில்லிங் ஒன்ஸ் கிங் ஆர் த ரூலர். இட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ரெஜிசைட். கேன் எனி ஒன் ஸ்டூடெண்ட் டெல் மீ த டிஃபரன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் murder and assassination? Anybody? Can anyone unmute your mic and tell me what is the difference between the terms murder and assassination?
Sir, if normal people is murdered, it is murder, sir. If any good. VIP is dead, it is assassination.
Not natural death. It must be killed. Very good. Very good, Vinayaswamy. Yes. Very good. Very good. Killing is same. If the person who is killed is a VIP, his death will be described, his killing will be described as an assassination. Rajiv Gandhi, Indira Gandhi, assassination. If anyone kills me, that becomes an ordinary murder. என்னை மாதிரி ஒரு ஆர்டினரி மேனா யாராவது கொலை பண்ணாங்கன்னா ஐ எம் ஜஸ்ட் மர்டர்ட், ஐ வாஸ் மர்டர்ட் தான் சொல்லுவாங்க. பட் இஃப் த விஐபி இஸ் மர்டர்ட், இட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் அன் அசாசினேஷன். பார்த்தீங்கன்னா சாவு கூட என்ன செய்யும், கௌரவமான சாவு வேணும்னா விஐபியா இருக்கணும், ரைட். கருவறை முதல் கல்லறை வரை சில்லறை தேவை. கருவறை முதல் கல்லறை வரை என்ன வேணுமா, சில்லறை தேவை. ஈவன் இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு குளோரிஃபை யுவர் ஓன் டெத், யூ கேன் சி இன் கிரேவியார்ட்ஸ். கிரேவியார்ட்ஸ் பார்த்துருப்பீங்கல்ல, நிறைய கிரேவியார்ட்ஸ் பாருங்க. சில கிரேவியார்ட்ஸ் எப்படி இருக்கும், வெறும் மண்மூடி போயிருக்கும். சிம்பிளி தே வில் பி பரீட் அண்ட் பி ஃபர்காட்டன். In some graveyards, they will say, lay some stones, memorial stones. So, there is a stone that is put in a deep hole. In some tombstones, we come across cement pavements, cement blocks. In some other cemeteries, we come across granite stones, beautifully decorated. They may even construct a beautiful building, right? They will do all kinds of things. What is the difference here? Even in the graveyard, we come across differences. Differences based on money, power and status. So even in death, we need honor, we need money in order to get a decent burial, in order to get a decent cremation. That is the status of today. Okay, that is the power of money and wealth. Okay, coming back to Macbeth here. When we talk about Macbeth, I told you we are going to witness a tragedy where Macbeth is the central character or the protagonist, right? And one important thing is, I told you we have to understand that Shakespeare has borrowed the theme of Macbeth from Holinshed's Chronicle and modified the character of Lady Macbeth with some elements of Seneca. Right. So this is a brief introduction for the sources of Macbeth. Now we get into the text itself. Let me share my screen now. You can see the text which I have already shared in the Google Classroom way back when we started the classes. Now you can see the screen. Let me present my screen now. Can you see the text now? Original text is also given alongside modern text is also given. Can you see the text now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, we start with Act 1, Scene 1. Just look at the backdrop here. Thunder and lightning. In the opening scene of the plays are called as exposition. I think you remember the term called exposition. What is exposition? In the exposition part, we have the setting, the backdrop, the major characters, the mood of the play is set. What kind of play we are going to witness will be also revealed. Whether it is a play is going to be a tragedy or a comedy, we will be aware of it, right? All these things will be exposed, and that is why the opening scenes of the text or the plays are called as exposition. Exposition. In Act 1 itself, we come across all major characters. Okay. In Act 1, Scene 1, the backdrop is thunder and lightning. So what kind of backdrop is this? Is it a peaceful one? Is it a very peaceful kind of backdrop? Thunder and lightning? No. We have thunder and lightning refers to confusion and chaos. Confusion and chaos. Idi minnal maranda eppadi irukum adu oru bayam erpadutra feeling varum. The audience who are witnessing the play in a live manner on the stage, when they hear the noises of thunder and lightning, they understand that the play is going to be filled with violent actions, right? Filled with violence. That is why we have thunder and lightning. This is one technique used by Shakespeare, that is preparing the mindset of the audience to witness a tragedy. Audience also understand that the play they are going to witness, the story they are going to see, will not be a smooth one, will be a very violent one. This clue can be understood from the backdrop, thunder and lightning. Who are the characters here? We have three witches as characters. Not one, but three. We have three witches. Okay. And the first witch, and another important thing to be noted here is, these three witches are females, but they also have beards. Daadi irukku. Females na, witches na, ana enna unkaamta? Daadi oda koodiya pomba pisasu. Witches. Okay. So we have three witches in scene one. Let us start with the first witch. So when shall we three meet again? Is it thunder, lightning, or in rain? We have the modern text in side by side. So we'll meet when the noise of the battle is over. So from the second witch, we understand a battle is going on. When the battle is lost and won means one side has to lose the battle, the other side will win the battle. So let us wait to meet again till the battle is over. Okay. So when will the battle be over? The battle will be over before sunset. That is an unwritten law in battlefield, right? Even in Hindu mythology, in Mahabharata, Ramayana, we also come across such scenes. No warrior will fight after sunset. Surya udayathukku appuram enna seiya mattanga? Sanda poda mattanga. Okay. Again, first witch asks, where should we meet? So let us fix the place where to meet. Let us meet in the heath. H-E-A-T-H. Heath. Here in the modern text it is given only as an open field. But the original meaning for the word heath, when you try to look at the etymology, what is etymology? Etymology refers to the study of the origin of words. Study of the origin of words. Heath refers to a barren, uncultivated, raised kind of land, piece of land. Not only a plain open field, it is a barren, uncultivated, unfertile, and a rough kind of field is called as a heath. Now look at the setting now. Thunder, lightning, battlefield, a fight was going on, and they are planning to meet on a heath, upon the heath. A barren field. Barren means empty. எதுவுமே விளைவதற்கு தகுதியற்ற நிலம், தரிசு நிலம். அப்படிப்பட்ட ஒரு ஓபன் ஃபீல்ட மீட் பண்ணுவோம்னு டிசைட் பண்றாங்க. ஓகே. So whom to meet now? Time நல்லா கவனிங்க. Time is before sunset. எங்க மீட் பண்ண போறாங்க? ஹீத்ல மீட் பண்ண போறாங்க. Whom are they going to meet? They are planning to meet the protagonist Macbeth himself. Right. The witches hear the calls of their spirit friends. They also have friends, spirits. unfamiliar, which look like animals. One spirit is looking like a cat. Another spirit is looking like a toad, a frog. Right? The witches enna seiraangala avangala spirit friends koopidra mari or scene vechirukanga. First witch calling to her cat. The cat's name is Grey Malkin. The spirit of a cat is called as Grey Malkin. Next spirit, second witch, she calls to her spirit, that is a frog, Paddock. My toad means frog. Third witch to her spirit, I'll be right here, I'm coming. And the last line spoken by all the three witches, look at the words here. Fair is foul, and foul is fair, hover through the fog and filthy air. My dear students, please read the lines very carefully. This is the theme of the entire play. What is the theme of the play? Fair is foul and foul is fair. What do you mean by the term fair is foul and foul is fair? Foul means evil. Fair is foul. What appears fair to the witches is foul for Macbeth and the people. அந்த விச்சஸுக்கு நல்லதா தெரியறது நமக்கு ஃபவுலா தெரியும், பேடா தெரியும். விச்சஸுக்கு பேடா தெரியறது நமக்கு நல்லதா தெரியும். ரைட்? தட் இஸ் த பிளேயிங் வித் த வேர்ட்ஸ் ஃபேர் அண்ட் ஃபவுல். ஃபேர் இஸ் ஃபவுல் அண்ட் ஃபவுல் இஸ் ஃபேர். வாட் அப்பியர்ஸ் டு பி ஃபேர் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி ஃபவுல். பார்க்க நல்ல விதமா தெரியக்கூடிய விஷயங்கள் மோசமானதாக இருக்க போகின்றன. பார்ப்பதற்கு மோசமாக தெரியக்கூடிய விஷயங்கள் நல்லதாக அமைய போகின்றன. இந்த மூணு விச்சஸும் அப்படி சொல்லிட்டு போகுது. என்ன அப்படி அமைய போகுதுங்கிறத பார்க்கலாம். லெட் அஸ் மூவ் ஆன் டு ஆக்ட் 1 சீன் 2. ஐ அம் கிளியர் வித் ஆக்ட் 1 சீன் 1? மை டியர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், இஸ் இட் கிளியர்? ஷால் வி ப்ரோசீட் டு தி சீன் 2?
எஸ் சார்.
ஓகே. கேன் எனிஒன் சம்மரைஸ் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் இன் சீன் 1? Any one of you?
Sir, shall I?
Yeah, please, very good. Do it, ma.
Yeah, ma'am. So, tell me what you're saying. The play starts with the thunder and lightning. That's why we start the tragedy form at thunder and lightning. And they are in the...
Number one, very good. Number one point, the play starts with thunder and lightning. Very good, ma. Continue. Number two.
Yeah, so next, and they are in the battle screen. And the battlefield is heap, no cultivated land. They are waiting for the mad bird.
Okay, very good.
And the three witches start to speak conversation with the three witches. And the main theme is fire is foul and foul is fair.
வெரி வயலண்ட் ஒன் பிகாஸ் தி பேக்ரவுண்ட் இஸ் ஃபில்ட் வித் தண்டர் அண்ட் லைட்னிங். நம்பர் ஒன். நம்பர் டூ, தே ஆல்சோ we also come across the three witches in the opening scene itself. Instead of showing hero in Tamil films, we come across, especially films of mass heroes, right? There is an opening scene how the hero is introduced. They will give a huge build up, right? Hero introduction. But here we are introduced to three witches. Point number two, one is the thunder and lightning. Point number two, we come across witches adding to the suspicion, adding to the violent effect. Number three, the witches also talk about battle, a fighting scene, a fight. Who is fighting? Macbeth is involved in a fight. Okay. Now they are going to fix the meeting place. What is it? They are going to meet in sunset. The place is going to be the heath. Whom are they going to meet? Macbeth. So that is what the three witches decide. Even, please remember, after sunset, again, there is a clue for darkness. In our homes, people say that we don't do anything after sunset, right? If you want to do anything good, please don't do it in sunset. Do it in broad daylight. நம்மூர்ல சொல்லுவாங்க பாத்தீங்களா, எதாவது பகல்ல பண்ணுப்பா, எதா இருந்தாலும் பகல்ல பாத்துக்கலாம், காலையில பாத்துக்கலாம், சாயந்தரம் பண்ணாதீங்க, இரவு நேரத்துல பண்ணாதீங்க, நல்ல காரியத்தை பண்ணாதீங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. ஏன் சொல்றாங்க? Practical reasons are also there. Even it happens in my own homes. Whenever my father brings some anything new or any new electronic equipment, or even when he first time we purchased a computer and it reached our home only at 8 o'clock, and as a small boy, I was a small boy of 18 or 19 years old when I received my first computer, I was so eager to open the box, but my father prevented me, saying that open the box, it is meant for you, plus but please do it in the morning, wait till the morning. But can we wait? நமக்கு வெயிட் பண்ண முடியுமா? We are so eager, we are so enthusiastic to look at the computer, right? We want to open the box in the night itself. But elderly people, they always say that, do it in the daylight. இதுக்கு பிராக்டிக்கலாக ஒரு காரணம் இருக்குது. என்ன காரணம்? இப்போ ஒரு பேக்கை பிரிக்கிறோம், சின்ன சின்ன மைனூட் பார்ட்ஸ் ஏதாவது இருந்திருக்கலாம், சின்ன மேனுவல் இருந்திருக்கலாம், ஒரு ஒரு ஸ்க்ரூஸ் இருந்திருக்கலாம், நட்டு இருந்திருக்கலாம். நம்ம நைட்டு பிரிக்கும் போது என்ன இருக்கலாம்? இருட்டில் ஏதாவது மிஸ் ஆகிருக்கலாம், நைட் டைமில் கிளியராக பார்க்க முடியாது, ஏதாவது மிஸ் பண்ணிடுவோம். அதுக்காக தான் என்ன சொல்கிறாங்க, பகலில் செய்யுங்க இந்த வேலையை, பிரிக்கிற வேலையை காலையில் பாரு, அது வரைக்கும் வெயிட் பண்ணுங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாங்க, ரைட்? And finally, as Sri Gayu has rightly said, fair is foul and foul is fair. Witches-க்கு ஃபேராக இருக்கிறது நமக்கு ஃபவுலாக இருக்கும், அல்லது மேக்பத்துக்கு ஃபவுலாக இருக்க போகுது, அல்லது மேக்பத்துக்கு ஃபவுலாக தெரிகிறது விச்சஸுக்கு ஃபேராக தெரிய போகுது. ஸோ த பிளே இஸ் கோயிங் டு பி ஃபில்ட் வித் வயலன்ஸ் அண்ட் சஸ்பென்ஸ் அண்ட் த்ரில்லிங் சீன்ஸ். தட் இஸ் வாட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு விட்னஸ். ஸோ இன் ஆக்ட் ஒன் சீன் ஒன் வி ஹாவ் ஒன்லி த்ரீ கேரக்டர்ஸ், only three witches, right? Remember the words sunset, heath, battlefield, right? And fair is foul and foul is fair. Shall we proceed to scene 2?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The alarm sound is given.
Yes, sir.
Enter King Duncan, Malcolm, Donald Bain, Lennox with attendants, meeting a bleeding captain. Make note of the characters in scene 2. We have King Duncan. He has two sons named Malcolm and Donald Bain, the princes. King Duncan had two sons named Malcolm and Donald Bain. We also have a character called Lennox, and finally we have a bleeding captain, a wounded captain. King Duncan begins the conversation. What bloody man is that? I think he can give a report from the latest news from the battlefield. The captain has returned from the battlefield and he is about to give a report. This is the brave sergeant who fought to keep me from being captured, Malcolm says. This is the brave sergeant who fought and prevented me from being captured, because I would be captured by the traitors. Hail, brave friend. Hail means praise. Tell the king what was happening in the battle when you left it. நீங்க வரும்போது என்ன நடந்துச்சுங்கிறத ரிப்போர்ட் பண்ணுங்க. Give a report to the king. The captain says, for a while you couldn't tell who would win, because in the beginning it was doubtful that we are not very sure about which force is going to win the battle, because they were equally powerful. The armies were compared to two exhausted swimmers. Swimmers who were exhausted, who were, what do you mean by exhausted? Tired, dead tired. Two exhausted swimmers clinging to each other and struggling in the water, unable to move. And we also come across a report about a rebel, R-E-B-E-L. Please make a note of this character. Rebel மக்டோன்வால்ட். ரிபல் ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு புரட்சியாளர், ஒன் ஹூ கிரியேட்ஸ் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் வித் த கிங்ஸ் ரூல் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் அ ரிபல், புரட்சியாளர். ஹிஸ் நேம் இஸ் மக்டோன்வால்ட். மேக் அ நோட் ஆஃப் இட், எழுதிக்கங்க. Write down the list of characters. We have seen the three witches. We have seen King Duncan. We have seen Malcolm and Donald Bain, Lennox. And we also have a report about a rebel named Macdonald. He was supported by foot soldiers, Taraipadai, and horsemen from Ireland. So King Duncan was the king of Scotland, as I told you in the introduction. King Duncan was the king of Scotland. Macbeth is his loyal military general. Make a note of it. King Duncan was the king of Scotland. He had two sons, Malcolm and Donald Bain. Macbeth was a faithful and loyal general. G-E-N-E-R-A-L. General, military general of King Duncan. And he is also a cousin to King Macbeth. King Macbeth's own cousin. That is uncle. Macbeth's Duncan uncle. Right. So, the rebel Macdonald was supported by foot soldiers and horsemen from Ireland. Scotland was waging a war against Ireland. Another country is called as Hebrides. H-E-B-R-I-D-E-S. Ireland and the Hebrides or Hebrides. The luck was with him initially. And what happens? After Macbeth's fight, luck departed from Macdonald. Macdonald did not have much luck. Macbeth was very, very brave. He was laughing at luck. He was chopped at his way through Macdonald. Right. Now, kindly look at the original text. I want to highlight the beautiful lines of Shakespeare here. Why do we call Macbeth to be brave Macbeth? Look at the words here. I have highlighted the passage here. For brave Macbeth, well, he deserves that name, disdaining fortune, with his brandished steel. What is brandished steel means? The sharp sword Macbeth was carrying. What happens is, when Macbeth was fighting against the Macdonald and other enemy soldiers, his brandished steel, the sharp sword, started smoking. Just imagine. The sword started emitting smoke. How is it possible? Because of the swift movement of the sword, the steel started smoking with blood. Macbeth was able to move or sway the sword in such a great speed, and due to the friction, the bodies were cut, the enemy soldiers' bodies were cut, and the blood started smoking from the steel. Just imagine how poetic the words of Shakespeare are. And the blade would have speed leh, ஃப்ரிக்ஷனில் பிளட்டு பட்டு என்ன ஆகுதான், ஆவி ஆகுதான். ஸ்மோக் ஸ்டார்டட் எமர்ஜிங் ஃப்ரம் த ஸ்வார்ட் ஆஃப் மேக்பத். தட் இஸ் த பவர்ஃபுல் ஸ்வே ஆஃப் மேக்பத். தட் இஸ் வை பீப்புள் கால் யூ மஸ் பிரேவ் மேக்பத். ரைட். அண்ட் ஹவு டஸ் ஹீ கில் மேக்டோன்வால்ட்? ஹீ ஸ்பிளிட் ஹிஸ் பாடி இன் டு டூ ஃப்ரம் ஹிஸ் நேவல் டு ஹிஸ் ஜா போன். எங்கிருந்து நேவல்ல என்னப்பா, கால் எங்கிருந்து பிரியுதோ தொடையிலிருந்து அவனுடைய நாடி வாய்ப்பகுதி வரைக்கும் ரெண்டா கிழிச்சு போட்டான் அவன். He was split into two. அப்படின்னா என்ன பவர்ஃபுல் ஃபோர்ஸை வெட்டிருப்பாரு, இமேஜின் பண்ணி பாருங்க. ஈவன் வென் பீப்புள் வென் தே ட்ரை டு கட் த ஹெட் ஆஃப் த கோட்ஸ் இன் பீப்புள் இன் டெம்பிள்ஸ் ஆஃபரிங்ஸ், ரைட், பார்த்துருப்போமா, ஞாபகம் இருக்கா? ஒரு பெரிய அருவா ஆடுத்து என்ன செய்வோம், ஆட்டு தலையை துண்டா வெட்டுவாங்க. அதுக்கு என்ன செய்யணும், வி நீட் கிரேட் ஃபோர்ஸ். பட் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் ஹியர் இஸ், மேக்பத் வித் ஹிஸ் கிரேட் ஃபோர்ஸ் கட் ஓபன் த என்டையர் பாடி ஆஃப் மேக்டோன்வால்ட் from his navel to his jawbone and struck his head on our castle walls. நம்ம கோட்டை சுவத்துல அவன் தலையை வெட்டி துண்டா எடுத்து என்ன செஞ்சானா, பாடியை ரெண்டா கிழிச்சாச்சு. His head was placed on our castle walls. Right. That is how the head of Macdonald was placed on the castle walls to create fear. Right. Duncan was extremely happy. Oh, my brave relative, my brave cousin, worthy gentleman. What a worthy man, Macbeth is. The captain continues, but in the same way that violent storms always come, just the spring appears. Our success against Macdonald created new problems for us. Listen to this, King. As soon as we sent those Irish soldiers running for cover, Scotland was fighting against Ireland. Now, who actually, another king joined the forces, that is from Norway. The Norwegian king saw his chance to attack us with fresh troops and shiny weapons. So, Scotland was waging a war against both Ireland and Norway. The rebel is none other than Macdonald, who joined forces hands with Ireland and Norway. Right. So, the fresh attack came from the Norwegian king with his new supply of weapons and soldiers. Duncan says, didn't this frighten our captains Macbeth and Banquo? He also talks about another character called Banquo, who is another major general, military general. No. How will they be afraid? The new challenge of Norwegian forces scared them about as much as sparrows frightened the eagles or rabbit frightened a lion. Sparrows, eagles, or rabbits can frighten a lion. It is impossible, right? Am I right or not? Sparrows cannot frighten eagles. Rabbits cannot frighten a lion. To tell you the truth, they fought the new enemy with twice as much force as before. They fought with twice the power. They were like cannons loaded with double ammunition. Right? With the two cannonballs. Cannonballs means birangi gundugal. Maybe they wanted to take a bath in their enemy's blood or make that battlefield as infamous as Golgotha, where Christ was crucified. Christ enna siluvil arange edathukku peran adupa Golgotha. Right? And edathula Christ enna senjanga siluvila vechi aranjanga. Right? That was filled with blood. But I feel weak. My wounds must be tended to. The captain was bleeding and he needs a doctor. Right? Your words, like your wounds, bring your honor. Take him to the doctor. The captain, the wounded captain, was taken to the hospital to be attended by doctors. Next comes, the captain exits and attendants are enter with two messengers named Ross and Angus. Who is this? Malcolm says, the worthy Thane of Ross. Thane is a title given to soldiers and lords. Prabhukalukku valangapadakoodiya pattathukku per dhaan Thane. Appadi patta oru Thane vandirukkaru, oru per Thane of Ross. Right. Lennox. His eyes seem frantic. He looks like someone with a strange story to tell. Ross says, God save the king. Where have you come from, worthy Thane? Great king, I have come from Fifi, where the Norwegian flag flies, mocking our country and frightening our people. Leading an enormous army and assisted by the disloyal traitor, another traitor is named as the Thane of Corder. Make a note of it. Very important information here. The Norwegian king was leading an enormous army with the help of a person from our side. His name is the Thane of Corder. C-A-W-D-O-R. He is the Thane of Corder. He has become a traitor. Or enna maaritaru? Traitor a maaritan. Traitor na drogi. Actually, he belongs to Scotland. Now he has become a traitor and he has joined with the king of Norway. We also had a rebel. Or rebel பேர் பார்த்தோம் யாம் இருக்கா? His name is MacDonald. Your traitor. He is the thane of Corder and he joined the king of Norway and began a bloody battle. Macbeth met the Norwegian attack shot for shot as if he were the goddess of war's husband. Right? Finally, he broke the enemy spirit and we were victorious. Finally, the Scotland forces won the battle. Duncan was extremely happy, great happiness. Ross, so now Sweno is the name of the Norwegian king, wants a peace treaty. He has agreed to surrender. Norwegian king has agreed to surrender. We told him we wouldn't even let him bury his men until he retreated to St. Colm's Inch and paid us $10,000 as ransom. பணைய தொகையாக $10,000 கொடுக்க சொல்லியாச்சு. அப்பதான் பாடிஸ் இறந்து போன பாடிஸ் கூட எடுத்துட்டு போக அலோவ் பண்ணுவோம்னு சொல்லிட்டாங்க. Duncan says, the king says, the Thane of Corder will never again betray me. Go announce that he will be executed. துரோகம் செஞ்சவனுக்கு மரண தண்டனை நிறைவேற்றுங்கள். And tell Macbeth that Corder's titles will be given to him. Macbeth is going to get the new title that he is going to be the new Thane of Corder. Macbeth is going to enjoy a new title that is the Thane of Corder. இந்த டைட்டில் யாருக்கு வரப்போகுது? மேக்பத்துக்கு இந்த புது டைட்டில் கொடுத்து அவனை வாழ்த்துங்கள். ஏற்கனவே இருந்த தேன் ஆஃப் கார்டர் துரோகியாக மாறியதால் அவனை உடனடியாக சிரச்சேதம் செய்யுங்கள், தலையை வெட்டி எடுங்கள் சொல்லியாச்சு. Ross is a messenger. He says, I will go and inform him right away. Duncan says, the Thane of Corder has lost what the noble Macbeth has won. What is it? Honor, faithfulness, loyalty to the king. Right. This is the end of scene 2 of act 1. So let us stop here. We have seen initial two scenes of act 1. In act 1, scene 1, we came across the three witches. In scene 2, we came across the news about the battlefield from a wounded captain, how Scotland became victorious, emerged victorious against Ireland and Norway. எழுதிக்கங்கப்பா. Scotland waged a war against Ireland and Norway and emerged victorious because of the skillful fighters, two important skillful fighters named Macbeth and Banquo. 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 Macbeth and Banquo were two brave soldiers who fought against the Norwegian and Irish forces and ensured the victory of Scotland. King Duncan has won the war without taking part. அவர் நேரடியாக சண்டைக்கு போக மாட்டார். மேக்பெத்தும் பேங்கோவும் சண்டை போட்டு ஸ்காட்லாண்டை வெற்றி தேடி கொடுத்துட்டாங்க. டூ பீப்புள் வேர் ஆல்சோ டு பி பனிஷ்ட். ஒன் இஸ் த ரிபல் மெக்டோன்வால்ட் ஹூ ஜாயின்ட் த ஐரிஷ் ஃபோர்ஸஸ். மெக்டோன்வால்ட் நம்பர் டூ வாஸ் அ ட்ரைட்டர் ஃப்ரம் ஸ்காட்லாண்ட். யார் அவர்? துரோகி யார்? தேன் ஆஃப் கார்டர். ஹி வாஸ் கோயிங் டு பி எக்ஸிக்யூட்டட், கில்ட், அண்ட் த டைட்டில் இஸ் கோயிங் டு பி கிவன் டு மேக்பெத். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த எண்ட் ஆஃப் Act 1, scenes 1 and 2, right?